Los Angeles.
Scratch that morning itch on the home of the Woody Show.
You know.
Alt 98.7.
All in or all out.
LA's new alternative.
Portions of this program were pre-recorded.
You made it just in time.
What is it?
The Woody Show is back.
Whoa. And we are into another new hour. Insensitivity training for a politically correct world here on a Friday morning. Happy Friday, a hey-o to y'all. It's November the 15th, 2024. We are the Woody Show. I'm Woody, that's Greg Goring.
Hey-o.
There's Menace.
What is up, Woody?
Gina, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Happy Friday, Sammy.
Happy
there
Friday.
There is Seabass. Got the phones open, 877-44-WOODY. You can hit us up with whatever you got on a text. Friday check-in over to 22987. 724 checking in, saying, hey, good morning. Question, should I post on OnlyFans about my webbed feet?
Oh.
Both feet. I have men's size 11.
Oh, wow.
Damn, yes.
Number one in Mount Lebanon. Shout out to Mount Lebanon. Yeah. What's up, Mount Lebanon?
Make that money.
People are into that.
Yeah, why not? Do it.
Yeah, I mean, hey, if you can make some money doing it, I mean, yeah, the foot people are nuts.
Yeah.
Yep.
Web feet, I don't know, I mean.
You don't even got to show your face.
Are they into ugly feet, or are they into, like,
all
just,
types.
Is it, like, beautiful feet
the
only?
The eye of the beholder, probably the uglier the better.
Yeah. Maybe, I don't know.
Look at when they cross over each other, like they're crossing their legs. Have you seen toes like that?
That's,
no.
I think that's the bronze foot, right?
I don't know. I have no idea.
Like what foot?
LeBron James.
Oh, really?
Wasn't there, like, something about that? Was it him or somebody else?
Were the toes kind of crossed?
I'm not up to date on all my foot news.
LeBron
other
foot
than
news?
I just know, like, for whatever reason, the feet thing. But I always figured it was, like, the way the foot looks in a shoe or, you know, like, because they look good. Like, they're
right.
They have, they're painted up or, I don't know.
You know, yeah.
not like, disgusting. What's that show you were watching, Menace? There was, like,
oh,
a,
the Toe Bro on
the toe
Instagram?
Bro.
What?
Oh, yeah, that was brutal. Oh, that's basically...
That
Dr. Pimple Popper.
But for feet.
For feet,
so you'd probably like that, Gina.
In a way, I'm kind of jealous of feet people because what could be an easier thing to see that turns you on?
Yeah.
Right.
Like, I mean, how can you not see feet?
People
like,
walk barefoot
like we've said
all the time.
A thousand times, go to the beach.
Yeah.
See feet.
Yeah. Showing your junk.
Look at any picture. See feet. Like if I got turned on by feet, the world would be a buffet of hotness.
Yeah.
I don't get that people are over dramatic about seeing feet. That is odd to me. But the thing that does creep me out is those toe socks.
Because I hate those.
Or toe shoes.
Remember those shoes?
Yeah, I don't like that.
Yeah. Do not, and I repeat, do not Google the Toe Bro.
Oh,
why?
Yeah,
Toe Bro is on Instagram. It's a whole account.
I just Googled it, and it
I've seen some stuff. Menace has sent me some stuff.
Yeah. I'm out.
it's foul.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah. Yeah, but shout out to Mount Lebanon.
Yeah.
You know, have you know, I'm class of 95. Just got some email from them the other day.
Oh.
Some alumni.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Reunion time, right?
I don't know if it's reunion. They wanted me to sign up for something where everybody can kind of keep in touch and you have to pay like some fee or something like that.
I'm
like,
thanks. No. Well, next year's your 30th.
I wonder if they hit up Mark Cuban with the same thing because he's a Mount Lebanon
guy.
Alumni. He graduated the same class as my mother.
That's amazing. I love him.
I think they would be desperate for him to come by.
All right.
<You know? laughs>
That'd be pretty cool. Yeah. He could fund the whole thing, you know?
Yes.
877-44-WOODY. Hit us up with a text over to 22987. Got the DUIQ. It's our dumbass contest. Your chance to win something this hour. That's coming up. But right now, your Friday fail story. Idea to one big stinking mega uber ultra
fail
mean, you know.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I yeah, seven.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It's far from perfect, but it's far from terrible. All right, well, this has been getting a lot of attention this week. The new Wicked movie's coming out here soon. So there's a new Wicked toy doll for sale.
Oh, yeah.
But parents quickly noticed that the well-meaning folks over at Mattel accidentally put the wrong website on the box.
Yeah.
First of all, box.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It was supposed to be wickedmovie.com, but all these packaging, all the boxes got printed up with it listed as wicked.com, which is your mom already knows. That's a porn site, guys. Mattel released a statement saying that they deeply regret the error and they're taking action to ensure no future dolls have the incorrect URL on the back. So, I mean, fail, sure.
Fail.
But
awesome fail.
I saw a picture of the packaging, and it's not like it's prominently displayed. It's in a super small font, kind of right above the UPC code.
And kids don't pour over every inch of those boxes ever. So.
No. Well, and kids aren't going to look it up online.
Oh, no. Yeah, they'll never do that.
No, I'm saying, but they're looking for Wicked, the Wicked movie. They'll type in Wicked, you know, and I'm sure that's probably the number one Google thing right now.
Yeah.
So that's going to be the first thing comes up is the movie. It's not going to bring up the adult website first.
Right. Yeah. Type.com, just like it tells you to.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, but, I mean, as a kid, did you look at the boxes?
Oh, my God. That's what I'm saying.
No, we just tore it open. We just wanted the toy.
Dude, that's exactly what I'm saying.
Are you effing kidding me? Every toy you poured over, because you go over everything. If you're obsessed with whatever, toy, you know, from Wicked to Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Maybe you're a homeschooled nerd. I don't know.
I forgot reading in Venice. I forgot.
No, I mean, I remember as a kid, I'd sit there and I'd read everything on the cereal box.
Right, exactly.
That's because you were eating.
Yeah, but like the when it was a toy or something like that, like I just... You open it up.
Yeah,
you
the box was just an obstacle.
Yeah.
You guys are boring.
I just don't know how much of an impact or how many kids are really seeing any porn because of that.
Zero.
Not zero.
This one is from Westwood, Ohio, where you got this chick, Kathleen Geiger. She was hanging out at this apartment complex when her buddy Arthur, you know, they're just joking around. And at one point, Arthur jokingly requested Kathleen shoot him, you know.
You do.
For fun.
Yeah.
Fun.
Yeah. So Kathleen's like, okay.
All right.
And did it because she believed that the gun was empty. But unfortunately, the gun wasn't empty. She actually shot him and he died.
I'm not buying this story. My friend asked me to shoot him. I thought it was blank.
Excuse.
Well, yeah.
Kathleen charged with recklessly causing Arthur's death.
Correct.
And now calls Fail Jail her home.
Good.
Fail.
That's what I'm going to do. Should I ever shoot and kill someone? Dude, they asked me to and told me it was blank.
It was dare.
Yeah.
This couple in Louisiana wasn't making payments on their car, so it ended up getting repoed. And when the car was being cleaned out, they found a bunch of stuff in there, and the cops were called. Here's what the detectives found. More than 9 pounds of weed, 18 grams of mushrooms, some ecstasy pills, packaging materials for distribution, a semi-automatic handgun. The couple asked to come down to the storage yard to retrieve their, quote, personal belongings, and guess what?
What?
That's where they were arrested.
Oh, no. They had an awesome weekend planned.
So they're facing multiple drug and gun-related charges. So now, not only did they blow their car payment money on a massive drug supply, but they also failed to make enough drug dealing money to get those payments under control, you know, so.
Whoopsie.
What and they stored their inventory in the car that was at risk of being repoed. Like, just, there's so much dumb failness.
Yeah, that's how you
failed.
Idiots.
Yep, their fault.
I mean, all that stuff was a nice start, though.
You know, I love watching. I love watching the, there's a bunch of, like, repo guys that have Instagram accounts.
Oh, yeah.
They get some cars out of some pretty cool situations where the people think they're being slick. Like, they'll be the car that's parked closest to the garage door. There'll be a car parked in front of it.
Oh.
And so you can't really get in the driveway.
Yeah.
This mother effer drove up on the grass and he has that little arm that kind of sticks out and just barely hooks it. And he drags this thing, sideswipes a tree, but he's making off with the car.
Yep.
And you got to figure they're walking out going, how do they get that out of there?
Uh-huh. Exactly.
I'd like to see that.
And the people that try to like back the, they basically destroy the car trying to back it off the tow truck once it's already hooked up.
I know. Just give up. You lost. Yeah,
you lost. Make your car payments. So stupid. Yeah, but I love those.
I've seen the same ones videos. Where they can tow a car that's parallel parked between cars. How are they going to get that?
Pretty cool.
They do it within seconds.
Yeah, there's also an account. It's an Instant Karma account.
Oh,
and there was
I'm listening.
There was a really good video. This person that cut somebody off, And so the person honked at him, like, hey, because they almost got hit. You know?
What the hell?
Yeah.
And so the person then slows down, flips off the person, and then speeds off.
To victory, right?
Yeah, right.
Oh, no.
Complete, into the sunset.
Completely flipped the car.
Oh, nice. No.
What?
And flipped the car, and got major league hurt. And the person who got flipped off and cut off, they're just laughing their ass off. It's so funny. All right, this last one here. This is one of my favorites of the week. It's from Abilene, Texas, where you got this fella, Casey Miguel Ronaldo Ray Soares.
All right.
He goes to a Family Dollar store, goes to rob it, walks in, acts like he's got a gun, told the clerk that, hey, give me the money. Clerk says, hey, the register won't open unless a purchase is made. So Casey is like, oh, okay, buys some nail clippers. So the clerk rings up the transaction. The register does, it pops open, but the employee quickly closed the cash drawer as soon as it opened. So now Casey is frustrated, storms out empty handed. Well, except for those super sweet nail clippers that he just bought.
That he bought fair and square.
The cops were called, Casey arrested, and during questioning, he admitted to pretending to having a gun while trying to rob the place. Charged with robbery and resisting arrest, he was taken to Fayal jail. My favorite part is not only did he not get anything, he purchased nail clippers.
And he gave that money. Wow.
He lost money on the whole
thing. Idiot.
I wonder how many times they could have done that. He closed the register. Sorry, you got to buy something else. Tic-tacs.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. We got the DUIQ. That's coming up next. If you'd like to be our contestant, go ahead and give us a call. That number is 877-44-WOODY. That's 877-44-WOODY. It's where Seabass is talking to a drunk. Last week it was me.
That was awesome.
Yeah. From Menace's party.
It was lit.
With a little help from your wife.
Yeah. And I don't think this is not another one of the party clips, is it?
News.
Is it? Okay, so we got somebody else. It's just another random drunk that he talked to asking some trivia questions. On all you got to do to guess and win on this contest is try to figure out if the drunk person will get the answer right or wrong. If you can do that 2 times out of 3, you're going to be the winner of the DUIQ. Which we're playing next, 877-44-WOODY. Call now to play.
I like Menace because
I don't think he even knows he's funny.
Books? I mean, how much are they these days? Right? He just regurgitates words and it just happens to be funny.
Now, can you help me with the pronunciation of this?
Menace. Woody Show. Woody Show.